Dr. Shane Pak with Ruthless Spine. We're going to learn how the most disruptive medical technology at NASS in 2023 works and why you're interested in it.
All right. Well, welcome. This is the RJB, a single-use disposable navigation system. Unlike every other navigation system on the market, this is the entire system, the Android tablet and single-use disposable modules. These modules, you open up the sterile peel pack, yank out the battery tab, and it will connect wirelessly via Bluetooth to your Android tablet. It uses a sensor similar to the sensor in your phone that tells you whether the phone is upright or on its side. This is mature technology that has been used countlessly for a decade and you can rely on. The way this works is the module slides into these instruments that are modified, that are RJB compatible. And you can see a module inside this gear shift linky. And then as you move and angulate the gear shift, it will change the displayed angle. And if you can see that there, so the gear shift thinks that straight up and down is 0, 0. And then as I tilt the gear shift axially, it'll change the axial angle. And as I tilt it sagittally, it'll change the sagittal angle. And then how does the RJB register to the spine? Well, the RJB module registers to gravity. I will place the patient on the OR table. I will take an AP fluoro. I will rotate the spinous processes until it bisects the pedicles. Therefore, the spine is registered to gravity. The module is registered to gravity. And by the transitive property of navigation, the module is registered to the spine. No iliac bolt clamps or iliac screws, no spinous process clamps. It's very quick, easy. It registers within 10 seconds. No 20, 30 minutes of trying to set up the nav and programming the CT scan so that it will sync up. No worrying about whether the latest software update will crash or if it will actually work. Also, you don't need to worry about whether or not the arrays are filled with blood. If your head gets stuck in the camera, this will still work. I cover it with my hand. No problem, it's Bluetooth technology. Also, if you will notice, this is the only nav system in which you can take it and it'll still work. No other nav system can you do that with. So the workflow of this is after I rotate the spine to the true AP, I flip the fluoro to the lateral. Then I will take the pre-templated axial angle of the RJB, and I will, after I find my starting point, I will angulate the lanky until it's in the correct angle that I want, whatever angle I've templated on this side, and this side is the left L3. So whatever angle that I wanted, I will leave it there. Then I will advance the lanky, remove the lanky. There is another module with a screwdriver, and then I will put the screwdriver matching the angle, and then I will not switch sides, or I have my resident fellow do it, but in my case, I will not switch sides. I will reach over to the contralateral side and put in the screw using the RJB as a guide. And when I do that, that allows me to do both sides without switching sides. Very fast workflow. Then I move the fluoro to the next level, screw, screw, next level, screw, screw. I have done 10 screws in 8 minutes with this method, which is as fast as humanly possible, in my opinion, in order to see how rapidly with the correct workflow that you can do this. And the screws come out inhumanly perfect.
Thank you so much. Very impressive stuff. Who does this threaten?
Well, here's the thing. If you are interested in a nav solution that requires zero capital costs for your hospital, these are consumables. You tell your hospital if you use zero, you pay zero. If I, as a surgeon, would decide to change my mind and use another nav system, you pay zero. You use 10, you pay for 10. And if you have a small operating room that is space constrained, or if you want a hospital that would like to not pour money down the drain, then perhaps the RJB would be for you.
The advantage is to the system, to the surgeon, and then what's the advantage to the patient?
Well, we know that unnavigated screws, especially in the thoracic spine, have a high rate of malplacement. And so malpositioned screws are one of the leading causes for taking back to the operating room. So anything to improve the accuracy of screws will significantly improve the patient care experience.
Excellent. Congratulations on you're fully approved.
We are FDA approved and we are ready to go and market in the United States and anywhere that FDA approved medical implants are allowed.
Looking forward to the party.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.